Hello everyone. So today we are going to see about the rod gap and horn gap arrestors. So in the last class we have seen the protection against lightning strokes. What are the different protection schemes are there? So we have seen. So first we have seen overhead ground weights and ground rods and counterpoise we have seen. In the last, that is, we are having the lightning arrestors. How these lightning arrestors are going to be used, what are the different types of lightning arrestors are there, we have seen. So here in that different types of lightning arrestors, we are having rod gap arrestor and horn gap arrestor. So those we are going to see today. So here if we see the learning objectives of this lecture, the first one is to understand about the rod gap arrestor. The second one is to understand about the horn gap arrestor. So how this rod gap arrestor will diverts or will arrest the surge, that surge is due to lightning strokes, and how this horn gap arrestors are going to be works to send the lightning surge to the ground, we will see in this class. Okay. So first if we see the types of lightning arrestors, that is, first one is rod gap arrestor, second one is horn gap arrestor, the third one is expulsion type lightning arrestor, the fourth one is wall type lightning arrestor. So first we will see about the rod gap arrestor. So here in the name itself, it is a rod gap arrestor, means in between the two rods you are going to have the gap, in between the two rods you are going to have the gap. So that is, here it is a very simple type of diverter, and it consists of two 1.5 centimeters rods. The length of the rods are two 1.5 centimeters. Two rods we are going to use here, that two rods are 1.5 centimeters each, which are bent at right angles with a gap between them. And one line is connected to the bushings, which are near to the power conductor, and another rod is connected to the end of the bushings, that is nearer to the transformer tank here. So these two rods, rod 1 here it is, and the rod 2 is the last or below the one. So here the rod which is connected to the line and the rod which is connected to the earth. The below one which is, it is connected to the earth, the above one which is connected to the line. So in between that you are going to have the gap, that is called as rod gap. So here you are having the gap between the bushings of a transformer. So here you are having the bushings of a transformer, and in between that bushings of a transformer and the rod, whatever the gap is there, that gap is nothing but P. So that P must be, it should be more than 1/3 of the rod gap, it should be more than 1/3 of the rod gap, 1/3 of the rod gap. So because in order to avoid the puncturing of the insulation, in order to reach that, if the length between this bushings and rod, that is P, length P is lesser value, then what happens when the lightning stroke strikes the line, then that is going to be flows through the rod gap, and then there is a arc is going to be formed between the rod gap. So that arc may reach the insulator or bushings, then the bushings are going to be failures or bushings are going to be punctures. So in order to avoid that, in order to avoid the reaching of that spark to the bushings, we are going to use a perfect length, that is more than 1/3 of the rod gap. We are going to use the length as more than 1/3 of the rod gap. So these rod gap arrestors are mainly used on the transformer tank in order to provide the protection against the lightnings for the transformer. So here we are using a transformer bushings. So these transformer, for these transformer bushings we are going to connect the rod gap arrestor. So here under normal operating conditions, whenever you are having the normal power frequency currents in the line, so before taking place of this lightning stroke, then what happens, the under normal operating condition there is a normal power frequency currents which are going to be flows through the line. So here, so that line currents are not going to be sent to the ground because there is a gap between them. We are going to choose the gap in such a way that the normal power frequency current should not send to the ground. If that normal power frequency currents are going to be sent to the ground under normal operating conditions, then that is a useless, that is not a useful arrestor. So, it should not send the normal power frequency currents to the ground. Okay. So, this rod gap, whatever the rod gap is there, that is non-conductive one. So, that is non-conductive for normal power frequency currents. So, whenever you are having a surge diverter, that means a surge currents, that is whenever there is a lightning is going to be takes place, then for that lightning you are going to have the large amount of the currents. That large amount of the currents are going to be flows through the rod gap by having the spark between them, by having the spark between the rod, that means rod gap. So, how the spark is going to be forms means due to that large amount of the currents, whatever the large amount of the currents are there, so that large amount of the currents are going to be destroys the dielectric medium between them. That means the dielectric medium is going to be destroyed and the spark is going to be forms between the rod gap. So, in that rod gap there is a spark is going to be forms. So, that spark will continuously allows the flow of current, that lightning currents, that continuously allows the flow of lightning currents through the gap and to the earth. It is allows the lightning currents to the earth. So, until the lightning currents are going to be sent to the ground, there is a spark is going to be present, but there is a disadvantage over here. So, what are the disadvantages or what are the limitations of this rod gap arrestor, we will see. So, before going to that, so if you see the old time characteristics of this rod gap arrestor, so that is old time characteristics. So, here, so if I consider the currents in microseconds and voltage on the y axis, then you are going to get the old time characteristics of the rod gap arrestor, that is old time characteristics. As the time increases, the voltage is going to be decreases. At the starting, the voltage is very, very high value. As the time increases, as the time goes on, the characteristics are going to be decreases. That means, the voltage value is going to be decreases. So, here if you see the limitations, so after the surge is over, the arc in the gap is maintained by the normal supply voltage only. So, once the ignition of that arc is the sufficient by the lightning currents, when the lightning currents are going to be takes place, then the lightning, that means then the spark is going to be ignition, and then the normal supply voltage is sufficient to maintain that arc. That means the continuous arc is going to be present even though after the lightning stroke is going to be complete. So, that lightning stroke is going to be complete within very less time, but the arc is going to be present continuously after the surge is over. That means, the normal supply voltage is enough and the normal power frequency currents which are available in the line, those are also sent to the ground through that spark. So, that is a disadvantage of this that lightning arrestor, that is rod gap lightning arrestor disadvantage. So, due to that maintaining of the arc, that leads to the short circuit of the system. That leads to a short circuit of the system, that is the first point. So, if you see the second point, that the rods may melt. Out of the rods are there which we are using, those rods are very, very small length and small thickness. So, those rods may melt because of the higher amount of the currents. If you are having the excess amount of current through that, rods are going to be flows to the ground, then that whatever the currents are there, the lightning currents which may melt the rod gap arrestor, that rods are going to be melts, because you are having the large amount of the currents in the lightning, that is in the order of 10 kilo amps to 90 kilo amps. So, that much amount of currents are may be melts the rods. And the third one is the climatic conditions. If you consider the rainy conditions or humidity or temperature, so which is going to be affect the performance of the rod gap arrestor. And the last one, if you see, the polarity of the surge also affects the performance of the arrestor, whether it may be a positive polarity or it may be a negative polarity, which is going to be affects the performance of the lightning arrestor, that is rod gap lightning arrestor. So, due to the above limitations, so we are having the four limitations which we have seen. So, due to these four limitations, The above limitations, the rod gap arrestor is only used as a backup protection, only used as a backup protection in case of main arrestors. If the main arrestors are going to be fails, then these rod gap arrestors are going to be coming to the picture, and these rod gap arrestors are going to be works, and which will sends the lightning currents to the ground. So that is what happening here. And the next one is rod gap arrestor. So what we have seen till now is rod gap arrestor. The next one is horn gap arrestor. So that is horn gap arrestors are nothing but what? So there are here, there are two horn shaped materials. The horn shaped metals are going to be used here. So that horn shaped metals are going to be made in such a way that as we are moving towards the upward direction, the gap between them is increases, the gap between them is going to be increases. So here you can see that at the 1 you are having the smaller gap length, and at the 2 you are having the, at the section 2 you are having the gap is increases, at the section 3 gap is going to be very very high as compared to the 1, it is high. And again as you are moving upwards, then the air gap, the gap is going to be increases. So you are designing in such a way that the gap between the horns, which are going to be made with some metal, the horn gap is going to be increases as we are moving towards the upward direction. So here we are having the two elements, that is one is a resistor, another one is a choke coil which contains inductance, and the resistor which contains a resistor value, that is R. And here, so that resistor is not going to be allows the currents under normal operating conditions. So those are not going to be allows the currents under normal operating conditions. To avoid the flow of currents under normal operating conditions, we are going to use resistor R. And here we are having the choke coil. So that choke coil, what are the choke coil is there? So that choke coil is having the inductance, and it is having the impedance of XL. XL is nothing but inductive reactance. So XL is nothing but what? XL is equal to 2 pi FL. So for normal power frequency currents, for normal power frequency currents, that is what normal power frequency current means, for 50 hertz currents, for normal operating conditions, then it is allows the currents, sorry, it does not allow the current, because the inductance is more. And here you are having the power frequency currents means normal currents, then what happens? It does not allow the currents, but whenever you are having the transients, the sudden changes, for that sudden changes the inductance does not allow any currents. For sudden changes in the current, that is going to be allows because of the, that is going to be flows because of the lightning. When the lightning is going to be takes place, there is a sudden change in the current, that sudden change in the current does not going to be allows through the choke coil. So because the frequency is more, as the frequency is more means the reactance, inductive reactance is going to be more, that is XL is equal to 2 pi FL, F is directly proportional to the XL. So as the frequency is increases, that means the lightning currents are having the higher amount of the frequency, because they are going to be they are going to be have within the quickest possible time, the time period which is available, that lightning is available within the short duration of time means the frequency is higher. Okay, f is directly proportional to 1 by t. As you are having the small time duration means you are having the frequency more. So if you are having the frequency more means XL is equal to 2 pi FL, that means frequency is directly proportional to the XL, that means inductive reactance. So as the frequency is more, then XL is also more, that means you are having the more amount of the reactance means more amount of the impedance you are having, that means it does not allow any transients to flow through it. Okay, but whenever there is a lightning is going to be takes place, that means that lightning currents are going to be sent to the ground, and there is an arc is going to be formed between the gap, whatever the gap is there between that gap, horn gap, there is a lightning is going to be, that lightning causes for the formation of the arc between the horn gap, and that horn gap, whatever the arc is there in the horn gap, then what happens, that arc, the whatever the arc is there, that arc is going to be moves away from the gap, that means due to the air, there is a forced air is going to be available between the gaps, then that arc may reaches to the positions 1, 2 and 3. So, when it is reaches to the 3, so it is the length of the horn gaps is going to be increases. As the length is going to be increases, means it is not sufficient to maintain the arc. So, that voltage, whatever the voltage is there, that voltage is not sufficient to maintain that arc. So, if that voltage is not sufficient to maintain the arc, then what happens? Then the arc is going to be disappears, then after the surge is cleared, there is no arc. So, that is what the advantage over here. If you see the advantages of this horn gap arrestor, the arc is self clearing, the arc is self clearing. Therefore, this type of arrestor does not cause short circuiting. So, in the previous case what we have seen is, that is rod gap arrestor, in that rod gap arrestor, even though after the surge is clear, the arc is going to be continuously present, but here that is not going to be present. So, this type of arrestor does not causes any short circuiting of the system after the surge is over in the case of rod gap arrestor. But in the case of rod gap arrestor, we are having continuous present of spark. And second one, if you see series resistance, what are the series resistance is there? That series resistance helps in the limiting of follow current to a small value. So, if you are having any currents under normal operating condition, there is a resistor, that resistance does not allows the currents to flow through the earth. So, okay. So, that is advantage of horn gap arrestor. And next, if you see the limitations, so here the bridging of gap between the some external agency, that is birds, that birds can fall on the horn gap, and that may cause for the continuity of the currents. So, it is a one disadvantage. Okay. So, that means that may damage the device. And the next one is, the setting of horn gap is likely to change due to corrosion or pitting. So, this adversely affects the performance of the arrestor. That means, whatever the horn gap is there, due to the corrosion, the horn gap is going to be reduces, or that may be changes. So, because of that, you are going to have the performance is going to be changes. The performance of the horn gap arrestor is going to be changes. And the third one is, the time of operation is completely long, say about 3 seconds, because here the movement of the arc needs to be done, because from 1, 2, 3 positions, 1, 2, 3. After it is reaching third position only, it is going to be disappear. The arc is going to be disappears. The arc is going to be extinguished. So, it will take 3 seconds of time. Within that 3 seconds of time, the equipment may damage. That means, you have to perform the lightning discharge within a small or shortest time. So, as much as less time, you have to send the spark, whatever the surge is there, that surge to the ground you have to send. So, if you take more amount of time, that may leads to damage of your equipment. So, as here it is taking 3 seconds of time, so that means, in view of very short operating time of the modern protective gear for feeders, this time is far long. So, but within 1 to 5 microseconds, you have to send that surge to the ground. That is very, very quickest possible time. And the next one is, so due to the above limitations, whatever the above limitations which you have seen, so due to that limitations, this type of arrestor is not reliable and can only be used in second line of defense only. So, at the starting as a main arrestor, we are not going to use this, but it can be only used as a second line of defense, like the rod gap arrestor. So, rod gap arrestor we have used as a backup protection, but here this horn gap arrestor we are using as a second line of defense, as a rod gap arrestor. So, if you see the summary of this lecture, so in the rod gap arrestor we have seen there are many disadvantages or limitations. So, due to that, the rod gap arrestor is only used as a backup protection. And next one is, in horn gap arrestor we have seen, so there are many limitations also, there are 3 limitations we have seen. So, this type of arrestor is not reliable and can only be used as a second line of defense, right? Thank you for listening this class.